here's a quick look at how you can add some content to Padlet. This should work in any modern web browser or in the mobile apps as well. And all you need to do to get started is press the plus button in the bottom corner. From here you can choose what you want to upload. Is it going to be a picture or a drawing or a video or just some text? Whatever it is, Padlet will show you how to do that, and you can quite simply tap on the option you want. I'm going to tap on picture, choose a picture I want for my camera roll on my iPad, and then I'll put in a quick title and I'll write a description as well. I'm going to put my name on there so I know who's posted it on this board, because otherwise it won't show you the actual poster. When you're done, you can press the post button and it will upload onto Padlet. Sometimes this requires approval, so whoever made the Padlet board will need to go in and say yes or no to your post. You can use the three dots in the corner to edit your post as well if you want to make changes, or you can set a background colour on lots of posts as well, which makes them stand out from the crowd a little bit. You can also explore what's there already by tapping onto a post, and you'll get a nice big image if it's a photo, or you can read the text in more detail as well. Padlet boards come in lots of different varieties, and sometimes the upload process differs slightly based on the board itself. For example, on a world map, you first have to choose a location before you can upload your content, or on a timeline, you have to tap on the time you want it to show up. Here's a more freeform board where I can attach a piece of content to a particular year group. So I'll make a new post as normal, I'll go for a drawing this time and a lovely self-portrait. When the post is live, I can press the three little dots in the top corner to edit my content, and from here I'm going to choose link to other post. Then I can choose my year 3, year 4, whatever it's going to be, and that will do a connection between the Padlet as well. So there are lots of different ways of interacting in Padlet. This is just one really simple example, but the more you use it, the more things you'll explore. Hey, thanks for watching that video. Now, if you enjoyed that and you want to find some more quick tips for your iPad or to use in your classroom, do me a favour and press the subscribe button down below. That will really help me out, and it will help you keep up to date with all the latest tips and tricks on my YouTube channel.